Astrocytes play crucial roles in the brain. They are important for me as cells that provide maintenance and support for neurons. They regulate the chemical environment in the brain, and they're also important for the integrity of the blood-brain barrier, among their other functions. In terms of diseases, they're important for Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, and amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, but also they are involved in brain injuries, then gliomas, and neuroinflammatory conditions such as multiple sclerosis. The availability of astrocytes to researchers at the moment mostly comes from sources such as post-mortem brain tissue and surgical resections, if we talk about human astrocytes. On top of that, some of the researchers use mouse astrocytes that are derived from mouse brains and different animal models. So there are, of course, ethical considerations, and there is also limited availability of human brain tissue. So we are essentially overcoming those challenges by producing astrocytes from human pluripotent stem cells. We try to address a long-standing roadblock in the field, which is essentially the amount of time needed to differentiate human astrocytes from human pluripotent stem cells. So generally, it takes several months to differentiate astrocytes, and we were able to do so in about a month. During the brain development, astrocytes are essentially developed at later stages, and this is often recapitulated in the stem cell differentiation protocols. So because the neurons come first, often these stem cells would first differentiate into neurons and then to astrocytes. So by modulating some of this important cell pathways, we were able to make this process shorter and practically remove this roadblock, and now we can generate large numbers of astrocytes in a short amount of time. These astrocytes have been used for disease modeling, for astrocyte-specific diseases such as Alexander disease. And it's essentially a goal to use them in the translational applications such as disease modeling, drug screening, and cell therapy eventually. In the future, we see essentially a lot of projects addressing some of the neurodegenerative, neurodevelopmental, and also astrocyte-specific diseases such as Alexander disease to essentially find drug targets, but also use these cells for drug screening.